Sitting on the surface of Mars is a tiny little 4-pound helicopter named Ingenuity that's preparing to take its first flight. So today on Space Chat, I'll be talking all about Ingenuity and its upcoming historic flight on Mars. If you haven't been here before, Space Chat is the weekly show where I take your questions and I take a deeper look at Earth, the universe, and beyond. So without further ado, let's talk about the Mars helicopter. As I mentioned, Ingenuity, it weighs in at about 1.8 kilograms or 4 pounds, and it is the first ever Mars helicopter. It flew to Mars tucked under the belly, literally under something called a belly flap, of the Perseverance rover, which landed in Jezero Crater on Mars February 18th. So it hitched a ride aboard the rover, and after Perseverance landed, and after the mission team made sure that the rover was intact, shipshape, everything went great with the landing, the rover started looking for airfields, or places where Ingenuity could fly, and could fly safely. So once Perseverance found this airfield or flight test site, it was time. Now, it hasn't flown quite yet as I'm filming this. However, once they found that airfield, they could really begin the process of getting the helicopter ready for flight. Ingenuity, as I mentioned, is the first of its kind. So it's not that they're going to release it from the rover and it's just gonna start flying all around the planet, doing all sorts of cool science and exploration. We're not quite there yet. Because it's the first of its kind, this is what's called a technology demonstration. So Ingenuity's test flights will simply serve to show that it's possible to fly a helicopter on Mars, that the technology they've designed to do this actually works the way they expected it to. Now, it does have a camera on board, so we'll be able to get some cool images and things during its flight. In fact, it's already taken some images, but it won't be flying and zipping all over the planet just yet. In fact, the first flight, it will basically lift up off the ground, it will hover for about 30 seconds, and then land back down. Now, the team hopes to get up to 5 flights with the helicopter. With the last and 5th flight, they hope to get it a little bit higher than the other flights. But as we've seen with previous landers and rovers from NASA on Mars, they often do and last a lot more and a lot longer than expected. For instance, NASA's Opportunity rover, it was only supposed to last for, I don't know, a few months. It lasted for 5,000 days. So this is what we expect from Ingenuity, but it is possible that the Mars helicopter will exceed our expectations. Now, as I mentioned, this is a historic moment. Ingenuity, with its first flight, will be making the first ever controlled powered flight on another world. And there are a number of challenges with this. It might seem like, yeah, I mean, I can fly a drone in my backyard that looks just like this helicopter. Why is this such a big deal, right? Well, it's a big deal and it's a big challenge for a few reasons. One of those reasons is Mars is not like Earth. Mars only has about 1% of the atmosphere that we have on our planet. And so that means to lift something off of the ground, it takes a lot more, even for something this light and this small. It's a lot more challenging to get something into the air. So that's the main technological challenge. But there are other challenges as well. The other being the communication delay, right? So how this flight's gonna work is it's gonna be autonomous. The helicopter is going to take off pretty much on its own because those directions and those instructions will have been sent from Earth long before that flight is actually made. So they didn't just have to figure out how to fly a helicopter on Mars, they had to figure out how to do it autonomously, because even just sending an email to Mars could take quite a bit of time. So it's all set up autonomously, it's set up to work in this really thin, challenging atmosphere and environment. And the main challenge that some team members have talked to me about was really just getting it there, right? The Mars helicopter didn't fly from Earth to Mars, they hitched a ride on Perseverance. And launching, traveling, landing, etc., this huge and incredible piece of equipment, this rover, on the surface of another planet was no easy feat. It took years of preparation and hard work. The team had to work through the pandemic and adapt to meet their launch target dates. It was an incredible challenge from pretty much every angle. So while we might just see what looks like a toy drone lifting up off the ground and then landing, this is the culmination of an unbelievable amount of work. And while I mentioned this is just a technology demonstration, in the future, helicopters like this on Mars, they could travel where no human and no rover could go, down canyon walls, through challenging crevasses, all over planet Mars, where it might take too long or be too dangerous for even humans to go. And they could also potentially even assist future astronauts, collecting data, etc. So, again, this is really the tip of the iceberg for this type of technology, but with the very exciting upcoming flight, we have so much to look forward to. So that's just a little bit of an overview about Ingenuity. Clearly, it's very exciting. I hope that you all are following along to watch the test flight. It was originally set for the 11th of April, pushed to the 14th, but it's going to be pushed a little bit further to next week. We don't have an exact date and time, and of course, we won't have all of the data until after the flight because of that communication delay, but soon enough, it will be flying. So now I dive into the part of Space Chat where I answer your questions. So let's get into it. All right. Okay. Someone is a little bit concerned about the wind. Frank on Facebook asks, how does Ingenuity protect itself from windstorms? Wait, great question, Frank. So there's obviously wind on Mars, and we've seen over the years that the dust storms on Mars can get pretty scary. NASA's Opportunity rover, actually, its mission ended because its solar panels got covered in dust. Right? And it shut off and is no longer operational. And Ingenuity is also solar powered, so that is definitely a concern. And it is a concern when it flies, you know, there could be wind, etc. It could affect the flight in some way. However, the windstorms on Mars are not how they appear in media. For those of you that watched and loved The Martian, as I did, you may have seen Matt Damon's character, Mark Watney, being pulled and tugged all around by the Martian winds in this dust storm. It's not that crazy. It's not that powerful. It's definitely dramatized in the media. So it's not going to be, you know, chance of crazy windstorms really affecting the situation. However, the team members have said that they are factoring in wind into calculating this flight. But very good question. All right, Aha on Facebook asks, how many flights can we expect? Well, they're hoping for 5. That's currently the goal, and they hope that the 5th flight goes a bit higher than the last ones. Okay, so Paul on Facebook asks, how will this thing fly in such a thin atmosphere? This is a great question, Paul, and I talked about this a little bit before. Mars has an extremely thin atmosphere, just about 1% of our atmosphere on Earth, so getting something to fly from the ground, from sitting on the ground and fly upwards, is a huge challenge. But the two things that are kind of on Ingenuity's side are really lightweight, really tiny, like I mentioned, just about 4 pounds, and its blades go really fast, 2,400 rotations per minute. That's pretty fast in my book. And the team has done a lot of trial and error and testing here on planet Earth, trying to simulate those conditions to make sure that it can lift off. But again, like I mentioned, taking off in this thin atmosphere is a huge challenge. Okay, Stephanie on Facebook asks, what is Ingenuity's expected lifespan? So it's planned to make these 5 flights over 31 days. But like I mentioned with Opportunity and its 5,000 days on Mars, way longer than expected, it's possible that Ingenuity will last longer than mission scientists and mission team members expect. But currently it's set for a 31-day flight mission. Anna Maria on forums, hey, space.com forums, they ask, does this mean we'll get our first aerial look at Mars? I'll say yes and no. So we have seen Mars from the air. When we saw Perseverance land, there's that incredible video of the rover landing. We can see it descending towards the surface. We can get that great aerial view. However, this will be the first view from a helicopter, from a craft like this in the air. Perseverance will also be watching from afar, so we'll also get to see the flight from Perseverance's perspective nearby, which I think is pretty cool. All right, Romney over email asks, how will the craft be controlled? So, like I mentioned, there's a communication delay between Mars and Earth. It's a lot of millions of miles, right? It takes some amount of time for that information to travel. So they can't just pick up a remote control like you would flying something like a drone in your backyard. So they've set the craft up to make these flights autonomously, which was one of the main challenges of creating Ingenuity in general. Okay, Carl on Facebook, question from my 11-year-old. Great, great, awesome, very exciting. Can the Mars helicopter hop from Mars to Phobos or Deimos? Really interesting question. So no, it can't, unfortunately. So right now the Mars helicopter is just designed to make these tiny flights on Mars. Just kind of hover. They're testing to see if it's even possible. So it's going to be a really big feat for it to just lift up off the surface of Mars. It's not a fully realized, a full-blown spacecraft that can travel to another world. I think it would be really interesting though to think about what kind of spacecraft could fly from, for instance, Mars to Phobos. What would that spacecraft have to look like? What would it have to do to launch from Mars, travel all the way to Phobos, and then get through Phobos' atmosphere and land? I think that would be really interesting to think about, and I'm curious what you would come up with. All right, Leia on Facebook asks, other than searching for signs of life, what other purposes does Ingenuity serve? Great question, because Ingenuity actually isn't searching for life. So you may have heard me talk about this before, but Perseverance and the overarching Mars 2020 mission from NASA is to search for signs of ancient life on Mars. However, Ingenuity, the Mars helicopter, it's just one of the many technology demonstrations, experiments on board the rover. So it's not the main rover, it's not the main mission itself. It's just the demonstration to test this technology throughout the duration of the mission. Now, Ingenuity will be snapping photos. I don't know how those images might be valuable to mission scientists later on, but its intended purpose is not to search for signs of life. It's just, we're seeing if it's possible, because in the future, Mars helicopters could be really valuable for things like searching for signs of life or other scientific exploration. Patrick on YouTube, how big is it? Tiny. like I've said, it's just about 4 pounds, 1.8 kilograms, size of a small dog. I don't know if that's helpful at all. About this big, if that's helpful at all, it's pretty small. It's pretty tiny, it's pretty delicate looking. And it was all folded up actually inside of Perseverance. It had to literally like unfold and unfurl itself to get to the surface. All right, Haru asks, what caused the flight delay? So, as I said, it was supposed to fly on April 11th, and then it was supposed to fly on April 14th, and now it's been pushed to next week. So, all I really know right now is that there was some type of issue during one of the blade tests. So, helicopters have blades, right? They go in a circle, they spin, that's what kind of gets them to lift off the ground. And at first, they tested Ingenuity's blades really slowly at 50 rotations per minute. But then they tested them at full speed, 2,400 rotations per minute. And during that high speed, full speed test, they had some issues. So I think they're just making sure that everything is 100% good before they move forward. Now, one last fun fact about Ingenuity that I did not mention before is this Mars helicopter, while it's making history, it's also carrying a piece of history. It's carrying a little piece of one of the Wright brothers' planes from 118 years later all the way to Mars, which I think is really, really special. So that was all the time I had for questions, but before we go, let's quickly go over what's new in space. So recently it was announced that SpaceX will launch the Astrobiotic Moon Lander along with NASA's Ice Scouting Viper rover. So SpaceX will be launching those missions on their Falcon Heavy rocket. Also, a new study suggested that alien hunters should potentially look to the moon when searching for artifacts of ancient alien life. Also, the Japanese lunar lander iSpace will carry the UAE's moon rover to the moon in 2022, and a Northrop Grumman robot actually was able to dock to a satellite in orbit to extend its life. So this has been Space Chat. Thank you all so much for joining me. Join me again next Friday and every Friday. And as always, stay tuned right here at space.com. And if you have a question or you have a topic you'd like me to talk about, let me know. Tweet at us, send it to us on Facebook, email it, comment it anywhere over our social platforms or email us. All of our information is down below. Thank you again so much. Have a great weekend.